He became mayor of the borough in 1767. He lived and worked in the borough for nearly three decades, and he developed a warm and abiding affection for the town and its people. He determined that he would build at St Ives a mausoleum or tomb in which he would be placed at his death. He died in London on 29th of March 1811 and was not brought back to the resting place he had prepared. He built the mausoleum in 1782, and in 1797 he prepared an indenture which bears the date of the 29th of May in that year. By this indenture he appointed trustees, the mayor, the vicar and the customs officer, and he charged them with the duty of carrying out the provisions of the deed every 5 years on the 25th of July, being the feast of St James the Apostle. Since 1801, the mayor, the vicar and the customs officer have, generation after generation, performed the duties thus given to them. John Neill built his tomb, which we now know as Neill's Steeple, on August Hill, and we shall this morning, following the feast of St James, go in procession to the steeple to commemorate John Neill. So, this morning, we begin the John Neill ceremony by presenting to each of the 10 little girls here £5 each, and we look forward to their enjoyment of the celebration at the steeple. We also present to each of the two widows the sum of £10. And to the fiddler, as John Neill described him, for provision of music, the sum of £25.
One left for our master of ceremonies, Harding Lacey.
The money he left for this purpose, while enough in his time, 214 years ago, does not go as far today. But the trustees will, once again, as the trustees have done for 210 years, make the request that John Neill desired.
New grandson.
Good morning.
Ha!
We're from his own, shall we?
Joe, and though he had an illegitimate family, he had no legal legitimate.
See you around. I'm here.
Love should be his resting place, but he died in London and was not brought back until he prepared.
Get over this heather.